Hello, my name is Dirk Spannaus. I'm founder and CEO of 20zen in Germany. 20zen is a digital agency specializing in technology, marketing and consulting. And of course, marketing automation, especially with Mautic, plays an important role for us in our client projects as well. So how did I come up with the idea to talk about marketing automation from day one, especially in the product development and the early marketing stages for launching a product? Well, we've been a startup too. Almost 10 years ago, we came up with our own startup idea and would have loved to have known about marketing automation and especially Mautic a bit earlier. So that three young guys wanted to save the local dealers, the local retail. E-commerce was booming heavily at that time and local retail was afraid. They didn't know how to compete with pricing and everything. So we said, do online marketing and get your clients into your stores. Especially social media was a good thing at that time. It was not so much overcrowded as it is today. And the early movers clearly had their advantages. So we developed a platform called Webzunder that should help them use social media much easier, helping them to distribute content, engage with their community. A lot of tasks which were difficult or different from platform to platform. Our motto was business stays local, internet will support. Well, we worked as a bootstrap startup. We didn't have a lot of money for ads. We did PR, we did studies, we wrote blog articles, and we presented at conferences and events. We were looking for tools that helped us to get a broader reach, to write newsletters, to help them onboard on our platform. So we came across Mautic at that time and saw the potential it has. We would have loved it was there a bit earlier, but we started using that, especially for onboarding. Well, at the end, we understood we were way too early to the market. It's not about technology and tools for them, and our user did need help in strategy and in content. So they didn't want to let us save them. Anyway, we learned a lot about marketing and technology at that time, where now our medium-sized companies benefit from. So we had a lot of marketing projects as an agency with medium-sized companies, and marketing automation now also plays a more and more important role for them. So there are certain prerequisites for marketing automation from my point of view. Of course, you need to have a solution for a real problem. That's the basis for your business. You need to have clients who are willing to pay for that. But then, this is important, you need to have insights about your target groups. And also you need to have a proven sales process. Proof means it needs to be repeatable. You need to know the questions people ask in the beginning or at the end and have answers for that. Those steps 3 and 4 could also be achieved with a lot of manual and personal interaction, but it prevents successful marketing automation projects. I can only warn, if your client doesn't have a proven and reliable sales process, don't do marketing automation with them. You probably need to go back some steps and work with him to really understand what makes the client buy. But let's have a look into marketing automation from day one. So while we were talking about marketing and sales processes, we now go back into product development, which is much earlier. There are a lot of good models for first starting to find a solution, to shape a solution, and I love those models. Models are never perfect, but it's a great strength because it makes you need to think about your solution. So what I prefer are, for instance, the business model canvas or the value proposition canvas by Strategizer. There are other models as well, but I mean, it doesn't matter which model you use. They are different, but they make you think about your business process. Of course, you also probably work with personas to work about your target groups, but this is not the topic of today's talk. So what are the typical phases in product development? You start with validation. You need to make sure that the idea you have is really good and that you have very well understand all the requirements to make it successful. So the first thing is to have a problem solution fit. So this means your solution should very much cover the problem in its total. This doesn't necessarily mean that your product needs to solve everything, but it could be extended by services and partners. Also, you need to have a product market fit. This means, as we said before, you need somebody to pay for that and you can test that. The second step is then after you validated your product to start developing. Very likely you will build prototypes at this time in the process. You will use those prototypes, show them to friendly testers, get feedback, and always remember, if you're not ashamed of your first release, you probably released too late. And then all the time you also think about launching your product. So you're preparing your product launch all the time with it. And that starts with building up lists, collecting contacts from day one. Because a launch is much better if you have an existing list of contacts than when you try to start with an empty list. And across all those phases, you get to know so many people. So this helps you to make this launch successful later on. So I think the most important MauTech features for you as a product developer or as a startup are the following ones. Forms. Of course, if you don't know, then ask your contacts. A/B testing. Very good. You can test landing pages, you can test emails. And if you're not sure about what the right subject is to catch the attention of your target group, yeah, then try it. And it's called A/B testing, but it doesn't stop there. You can have so many variants and then evaluate which of the combinations are the best and have the best results, because you define your KPIs like opening rates or click-through rates, and then you will find out which version of your email works best. The stages model. Unlike segments, people cannot jump between those stages, and there's only one way that goes up. This means it also helps you to make sure that you deliver the right content to the right people according to their place in the sales process. But the most powerful thing from my perspective is tagging via API. This means that you help your clients to get step by step towards an achievement that you want them to see, to a wow effect. And I have an example for that. So how can you bring a client or a user of your platform to a wow effect? You know exactly what people need to do when they work with your product and to have their achievements. This means there are always certain tasks they need to do first before they can unlock, or before unlock sounds like a game. Before they can do the next steps with your product. So that's very individual. Some people take longer than others. So this is much more event driven and not time driven. Before we were working with MauTech, our campaigns were time driven. And of course, it doesn't make sense to talk to a client about the next step if he hasn't finished the first one. How can this look like event based? And I really like this because you only need a little amount of integration with MauTech, which is basically adding tags to your users. So for instance, you start with a registration campaign. You send the first email. You send the second email. Your user doesn't react. He has something other to do. You send the third. No, you don't need to send the third one because just now he registered. Your cloud solution sent back the tag registered to this client, and you can skip email number three. Next campaign starts. So first mail goes out. He should connect to a system. He did it, so you can skip it. So you can skip the other two mails that would belong to that campaign. I hope you get it. That's the idea, that have everything event-driven campaigns, and you make sure that you guide your early users to a wow effect, which makes it more, much more likely that they will stay with you, that they will upgrade, that you have a good rate of growing clients. And while we were talking about the early product development processes, how to design the onboarding process to better understand your client's needs, also your marketing and sales processes will probably start now. And I have another model for you, which is a very simple sales funnel. It could be much different for your process than this, but it helps understand the problem. I like easy models. So step number one, very likely potential clients are unaware of the problem. They have not heard about your solution. They don't even know they have a problem. So yeah, then how can you reach them? You can only do it by talking to them or to show them display ads if you can afford. So give talks and conferences and other events, create content, write blogs, write articles in newspapers that your potential new clients will read so that you generate interest, that you get their attention. So now in step number two, that they know they have a problem, are you sure they understand the whole problem, the whole problem completely? Help them understand the problem, because if you have the chance now to support your contact in investigation the issue. Only if this problem is getting big enough, it will climb on the top of the list of problems he has as well. So if you want to sell something, make sure your problem is big enough to care about it. So we have created the need of action. Step number three. Well done, your prospect is now investigating into potential solutions, but they are not yet investigating into your product. They will probably look into alternative solutions, maybe how they can have a workaround of their problem. So, but then help them investigate, show them alternative solutions, show them the pros and cons, give them checklists, give them the advantages and disadvantages. And you help them to get along. You're doing a good job. Your client will thank you for that later. So you kind of synchronize the expectations for the solution. And you have even given them a checklist to understand what is the best solution for their problem. And now we are talking about step number four, and that's the boss move. Now it's prime time. And now they are starting to evaluate potential products and services that can solve that problem. Show them your product. Let them check your product with your checklist you gave them. No problem if they check other products with your checklist as well. I think I know which product comes out best. Well, and if you started early understanding the real value proposition of your solution, what it's worth for your client, not what you think it is, then you make the sale. Congratulations. I also have two interviews with me today, because I want to show you how medium-sized companies are using marketing automation with Mautic in introducing their own new services and products. First is IntraSuite by IntraKey. IntraKey is an established medium-sized company, but Uwe Richter will tell you more in my interview, starting now.
Hallo Uwe, freut mich, dass du heute dabei bist. Stell dich doch mal kurz vor.
Hallo Dirk, ich freue mich auch sehr, bei diesem Interview dabei zu sein heute. Mein Name ist Uwe Richter und ich bin bei der Firma IntraKey in Dresden als Marketingmanager zuständig.
Was ist die Firma IntraKey? Was macht ihr?
Die Firma IntraKey ist seit über 20 Jahren Experte auf dem Gebiet der Zeiterfassung, Zutrittskontrolle und alles, was rund um das Thema elektronische Identifikation zu betrachten ist.
Also traditionelles mittelständisches Unternehmen, aber jetzt werdet ihr zum Startup?
Kann man so ansatzweise sagen, zumindest in Bezug auf das neue Produkt.
Das neue Produkt, das ist Stichwort. Was macht das neue Produkt?
Das neue Produkt, die IntraSuite Time, ist ein Cloud-basiertes Zeiterfassungssystem. Mhm. Wir gehen also hiermit völlig neue Wege, denn bisher waren unsere Kunden in erster Linie Hochschulen, Universitäten, mittelständische Unternehmen, größere Unternehmen aus der Wirtschaft oder auch kommunale Unternehmen bis hin zur Polizei. Mhm. Und jetzt bewegen wir uns in einen neuen Markt, in den Markt der cloudbasierten Systeme.
Da verändert sich wahrscheinlich auch vertriebsmäßig einiges, oder?
Absolut. Vor allen Dingen möchte ich noch mal kurz auf den Hintergrund eingehen, warum wir das tun. Da gibt es einerseits rechtliche Änderungen. Es gibt eine EU-Verordnung, die das Thema Arbeitszeit völlig neu regeln möchte und das muss jetzt noch in nationales Recht überführt werden. Mhm. Andererseits hat uns aber auch die Pandemie gezeigt, dass die Arbeitswelt sich weiter ändert. Ich nenne hier als Stichwort nur das Thema Homeoffice. Und auch das sind Themen, die Auswirkungen auf das Thema Zeiterfassung haben.
So, also neues Produkt, Cloud-basiert, andere Vertriebswege. Wieso seid ihr dann mit dem Thema Marketing-Automatisierung in Kontakt gekommen?
Einerseits natürlich, weil es hierbei um ein Niedrigpreissegment geht. Es geht um kleinpreisige Abo-Modelle. Und da müssen natürlich die Vertriebskosten möglichst gering sein. Mhm. Andererseits bietet uns Marketing-Automatisierung auch sehr viele Vorteile im Bereich Prozessoptimierung. Alle Prozesse rund um das Onboarding können wir automatisieren und haben wir auch automatisiert. Mhm. Es gibt viele Möglichkeiten, Feedback einzusammeln, den Usern Fragen zu stellen. Wir können einen Funnel aufbauen, können Interessenten gewinnen, zu Fans machen und dann auch zu Kunden weiterentwickeln. Und die direkte Kommunikation und das Aufbau von Kundenvertrauen über den Kanal E-Mail ist für uns auch ein wesentlicher Faktor bei dieser neuen Einführung.
Also 4 Punkte. Zum einen Vertriebskosten senken mit Marketingautomatisierung, das Onboarding, die Kunden zum ersten Wow-Effekt zu führen, dass sie auch dabei bleiben beim Produkt, ja, habe ich gehört. Die Kundenbindung, ja, dass ihr die Kunden halt auch ganzheitlich als Intra-Key betrachtet und vielleicht noch Upselling-Möglichkeiten findet. Und wenn ich es richtig mitgekriegt habe, auch Self-Service. Ne? Die Kunden können dann auch selber Prozesse anschieben, wie ein Upgrade beispielsweise.
Genau.
Okay. Ja, da stellt sich die Frage, warum Mautic, warum Open Source?
Einerseits natürlich aus Kostengründen, aber andererseits gibt es auch noch weitere Kriterien, wie der hohe Individualisierungsgrad bei Mautic, der uns ja gut gefällt. Wir können uns da in alle Richtungen weiterentwickeln. Es gibt eine große Community mit einer großen Offenheit für neue Entwicklungen, die ist sehr aktiv. Mhm. Andererseits sind wir aber auch oder haben wir auch als Softwarefirma ein eigenes Know-how, was wir bereits mitbringen und haben uns dafür auch entschieden, die Software selbst im eigenen Unternehmen zu hosten, was wiederum den Vorteil hat, dass wir die Kundendaten in-house haben und nicht abgeben müssen.
Das ist ja ein wichtiger Aspekt auch für viele andere mittelständische Unternehmen. Damit hat Mautic einen großen Vorteil zu anderen kommerziellen Lösungen. Gerade auch das Integrieren finden wir auch spannend. Ja, danke, Uwe. Zuletzt noch, wer sich zu dem Thema Arbeitszeiterfassung mehr informieren möchte, gerade auch die gesetzlichen Dinge, die du angerissen hast, der macht am besten was?
Der geht am besten auf unsere Website. Der Link wird hier nochmal eingeblendet und kann sich dort, wie sich das für ein Automatisierungstool gehört, seine E-Mail-Adresse eintragen und bekommt dann automatisch Informationen zu den ganzen neuen gesetzlichen Regelungen.
Finde ich super. Ich selber muss mich da auch informieren. Ich bedanke mich, Uwe, für dein Interview, für deine Zeit, die du...
Sehr gerne.
Ja, und wünsche dir noch eine erfolgreiche Woche. Und vor allen Dingen, dass die Intrasuite richtig rockt jetzt.
Vielen Dank. Wir sind erst kurz online, seit 2 Tagen. Und wir hoffen auf gute Resonanz.
Gutes Gelingen. Danke.
Dankeschön.
Well, all the best with your platform and growing your client base. For everybody who wants to learn more about time tracking and the legal aspects of it, you can go to their website, which you see intrasuite.eu, and register for getting more information. Yeah, and marketing automation is not just about emails and text messages, for instance. I really love that there is an interface to the Deutsche Post in Germany. Deutsche Post, German Post Office, is sending printed postcards, printed letters, which you can directly send from Mautic on a one-by-one basis. So they are highly individualized. You do not have to send 100,000 mails. You can send just one postcard, if you like, for one person at a day. So it has a direct connection with Mautic. And why is this important? It's a very good alternative to search and display ads. I mean, if you have lists of addresses of your clients, why not sending them a postcard? The good thing is also The postcard will probably be on their table for a while, while an email in the inbox, yeah, gets lost quite quickly by other emails. Also legally, it's an interesting aspect because you may send print mailings while you're not allowed to send emails to cold contacts by law. My second example for a startup who's using marketing automation with Mautic is Quattrolingo. These are translation professionals and they have the addresses of their potential clients. So they send out postcards to make them aware that there is a better way of getting clients for their translation business. But let's talk with Falk Neumann. He will explain us on what they are doing.
Hallo Falk, freue mich, dass du heute dabei bist und uns etwas darüber erzählst, wie ihr Marketing-Automatisierung bei der Einführung eures Produktes einsetzt. Stell dich doch kurz vor.
Hallo Dirk, danke für die Einladung. Mein Name ist Falk Neumann. Ich bin einer von vier Gründern des Startups Quattropus, welches die Quattrolingo-Software entwickelt und vertreibt.
Was macht die Quattrolingo-Software?
Ja, die Story begann eigentlich beim Kaffeekränzchen mit meiner Frau. Meine Frau ist mit Herzblut Dolmetscherin und Übersetzerin, ist aber schon seit langem unzufrieden, wenn Aufträge über Agenturen kommen. Mhm. Diese Auftragsvergabe ist sehr intransparent und Agenturen halten auch mächtig die Hand auf. Das geht bis hoch zu 80%, also lediglich 20% bleiben dann für den Sprachmittler. Und wir haben uns dann gesagt, das kann in der heutigen hochtechnisierten Zeit eigentlich nicht mehr sein. Da muss es ein besseres Konzept geben. Haben uns dann was ausgedacht und haben das dann auch mit Freunden diskutiert. Und je mehr wir diskutiert haben, desto besser wurde das Konzept. Und letztes Jahr haben wir dann gesagt, wir setzen das jetzt um. Und ja, haben auch Rücksprache mit potenziellen Kunden gehalten. Die fanden die Idee auch super. Und seit letztes Jahr sind wir also dran, die Quattrolingo-Software zu entwickeln und in den Markt zu bringen.
Das heißt, die Welt wird besser für Übersetzungsdienstleister. Was für Vorteile hat es für die Auftraggeber?
Ja, da muss man auch die Auftraggeber verstehen, wenn die einen Sprachdienstleister brauchen. Und manche brauchen ja häufiger einen, zum Beispiel bei Gericht. Dann müssten die theoretisch das Internet selbst durchsuchen und die Sprachmittler, die sie finden, nacheinander kontaktieren. Jetzt ist aber auch nicht jeder Sprachmittler sofort erreichbar. Also es ist eine sehr aufwendige Sache und aus dem Grund kontaktieren die auch gerne Agenturen und bezahlen dafür dann natürlich auch.
Okay, also Vorteile für beide Seiten. Ihr macht eine direkte Vermittlung. Wofür setzt ihr dann Marketing-Automatisierung ein?
Die Idee von Quattrolingo stößt überall auf Begeisterung. Sie ist aber eben sehr erklärungsbedürftig. Und wir müssen also jetzt lernen, auf welchen Weg wir 50.000 bis 60.000 Sprachmittler in Deutschland erreichen, und zwar schnell, damit die Idee schnell Fuß fasst und fruchtet und ja, die Sprachmittler davon profitieren können.
Okay, ihr habt ja schon einen Pilotbetrieb und so wie ich gehört habe, auch den ersten Auftrag erfolgreich vermittelt.
Ja, das ist richtig. Ich glaube sogar zwei. Das waren noch interne Tests, aber hat hervorragend funktioniert.
Super. Marketing-Automatisierung. Warum habt ihr euch da für Mautic entschieden oder beziehungsweise warum habt ihr euch für Open Source entschieden?
Ja, der wichtigste Grund ist für uns eigentlich mit, dass wir das System selbst hosten wollen. Hängt damit zusammen, dass wir die Kundendaten schützen möchten. Dann als Startup muss man natürlich immer auch auf die Kosten schauen. Und Mautic ist im ersten Blick nicht so überladen, bietet aber durch das Zuschalten von Modulen und Schnittstellen extrem viele Möglichkeiten.
Und so wie ich das mitbekommen habe, seid ihr ja eh Fans von Open Source. Ihr setzt verschiedene Tools ein bereits.
Ja, das ist richtig. Wir haben was gegen Datensammeln im Allgemeinen.
Okay, also was ich gehört habe, Nextcloud, WordPress sind die anderen Bausteine, auf die ihr setzt, zusätzlich zu eurem selbstentwickelten Produkt.
Das ist richtig.
Ja. Genau. Wie geht's weiter mit Quattrolingo?
Wir sind jetzt mit Hochdruck dabei, die Auftraggeberseite zu entwickeln. Die Sprachmittlerseite ist schon online und Sprachmittler können sich jetzt schon registrieren und dort ein Profil anlegen. Wir hoffen, dass wir im Juni oder Juli die Auftraggeberseite fertig haben und dann das Ganze durchstarten kann. Das Ganze
sehr schön, sehr schön. Ja, vielen Dank. Wir wünschen euch viel Erfolg beim Start und ja, viel Spaß in der Mautic-Community.
Dankeschön, ebenso.
Danke.
Ciao.
Again, if you are interested to learn more about Quattrolingo, go to their website and understand how a translation business can be done better than it ever has been done before. So what are my recommendations for starting with Mautic as a startup or a product development team? Well, start with adding segments for your multiplicators. This could be press, this could be bloggers, this could be friends, this could be business partners. So you always have somebody who you can write about your updates, about your progress, about your achievements. You don't even need to have a CRM in the beginning. It's much better to have a good communication tool to stay in contact and to let them know about the news. Number two, conduct research with Mautic forms. Which feature has been missing? Or why is this topic important to you? So your friendly testers help you early to understand what's important for your product and later on for your marketing and sales process. Stay in intensive exchange with your friendly testers. Do test with them, send them information about the new feature to test, let them prioritize your value proposition, what's important to them, for instance. Remember the example I gave you with integration. Do use Mautic for onboarding your clients. Understand what steps they need to go or which milestones they need to reach in order to stay with your product, to have the wow effect, as we say, that convinces them to stay with your product. And then finally, with help of all the contacts that you collected so far, you will have a much better launch of your product than when you start with an empty list. So could this be done without Mautic? Sure. I mean, there's a lot of products out there that you can use for those tasks that you have. For instance, collection of contact information or better understanding your client's view, prioritizing and validating products and features, doing agile development with customer feedback, preparing your onboarding campaigns, doing the sales campaigns, and development of further target groups. Sure, you can do this with a lot of alternatives, but you can also do it with Mautic. And that's a good thing. You have one tool which you can use for achieving all of those important tasks. So yeah, give it a chance. If you have not used it yet, use Mautic for your next product development. It will make life much easier for you. I'm now live in this conference. You can ask me questions. I will try to answer them. Otherwise, I get back to you later. You can also download this presentation from this link, which is, of course, an asset in Mautic. And I would love to get your feedback and talk to you. Thank you very much.
That was a great one, Dick.
Thank you.
All right. So let's move straight into the question and answer. So the first question I have for you here is, what are the most important skills to set up and run Mautic in product development?
Yeah. We always said in our team, and I needed to look this up as an English term, it's called set theory, Mengenlehre in German. So you need to know how you shape your sets or your lists, your segments, in order to reach the right people. So it's a lot of addition and removal from or overlay from segments that you can combine. So this is, I think, one of the most interesting or most important technical skills that you need to have. Also that you make sure that you use stages so that you, for instance, do not sell somebody an offer that you just sold your product. I mean, this happened to me like in the last days. I bought a new refrigerator, and this is a large German e-commerce retailer. And after I bought this this fridge, they still sent me push messages and telling me about other fridges I could be interested in. And when I was asking them, hey, why do you still send me recommendations? Why do you risk that I send back the first 14 days? You can send back everything. Why do you risk that I send back this machine? You already sold me. And it was quite surprising that even large corporations don't get that theory right. You should not have an offer for somebody who just signed up for your service. So this is one of the important things. And I think also it's important to have a good overview, a good structure, how you use tags, especially if you use tags to control your campaigns. you need to have an overview so that you not by accident push someone in a campaign that you didn't want to have there. So it's probably a good way to find a structured way and a syntax, how you use tags, how you name campaigns, mails, and forms, so that it's easy for you even after a while to keep your overview, to find out where a form belongs to, for instance. Yeah, documentation is the point. Yeah, and the other thing is, of course, you also need to get to use Tomautic and to learn step by step about the advantages of multi-language campaigns or even multi-language campaigns and A/B testing. That's what, yeah. So that's the technical side. On the other side, I was talking a bit about how you structure your content. And I think that's the marketing side. You need to know how you develop someone from being interested in wanting to buy. So that's, I think, the most important skills that also people who develop new products need to have from day one.
Okay. All right. Good. So, the second question is going to be focusing more on the examples that you used in your presentation. So I could see you use IntraSuit and Creatron Lingo in your example. Yeah. So are there other examples that you can be able to, that you can use for campaign that are useful for startup and product development teams? And another addition to that will be, as being a part of the marketing team, we love to hear stories about businesses like this. I would love to see where you can be able to contribute that as a use case or case studies that we can officially have as part of Mautic, whereby anyone can be able to say, hey, how can I use Mautic for multilingual? How can I use Mautic for real estate? And then you can point them to resources and say, hey, this is how someone is using it, or this is how you can be able to use it.
So for the first one, it's like kind of loud sound feeding back now, maybe.
Oh, let me mute myself. It's kind of raining here. All right.
Okay. So for your first question, are there other examples? Yes. So I showed one company is, for instance, Quattrolingo is using it heavily for the marketing, for getting users to the platform. So they are also sending postcards with Mautic, which I find really interesting, a good alternative to search and display ads. The IntraSuit is using it for the onboarding experience and for support. But I also think that there are other types of campaigns who are very useful, like the referral campaigns. There is a plugin from the Swiss company Matu. It's also a Mautic partner. They developed a kind of a plugin where you can let your people enter email addresses, and this will automatically also create new contacts. And so you can send in the name of somebody, you can send a mail and say, hey, Oliver Tobi just recommends you this service. Do you want to have a look? So if you make it smart enough, then it's not even offensive, like if you would do cold mailing. This is kind of a delegated cold mailing, right? So the referral campaigns, I think, are powerful. And also, if you run quite a while and you want to see if people are still as enthusiastic or about your service, then you can also do the NPS questionnaires, Net Promoter Score within Mautic. So a lot of different ways you can use campaigns without using any other tool, without needing to have any other any other software as a service, which is a standalone tool again. So you can do a lot with different needs in the time of product development. And if I understand the question correctly for the second one, if these references can be Mautic references, I will ask them. And I think they are, why not? Why not should we share those great examples for what people are using Mautic for? It's a good idea.
All right, that makes sense. So I will sync with you after this conference so that we can be able to see how we can be able to get that working. Mm-hmm. All right, good. So then one more thing, but this is not actually a question. So since I have access to the presentation earlier, so I tried to scan the BR code, go to the website where I can be able to download the presentation. But unfortunately, I can see that it was not in English.
Uh-huh. So I fixed it afterwards because this was something I did today. And okay. Thank you very much. I did the test drive afterwards. And now, if you start it again, I have a bilingual campaign. It's unfortunately, there are no bilingual forms yet. But so I have two different forms. I have all the mails are set up as translations, and based on your locale that I save as a hidden field in the form, I will then send out the mails. There was the mistake there was that I set for the second mail a German translation for the German translation. So it was wrongly coded email. So well, it should work now. You can try.
Okay, all right. So I'm going to fill the form again and then try it again.
Thank you.
All right, great. All right, so before you go, I want to ask Nidhi if there's any other thing you'd like to talk more about before you leave, before you go today.
I can only say thank you. It's a great event and it's interesting topics, and I'm looking forward to see all those other sessions as well. Thank you very much.
All right. Thanks so much, Dick. Catch you up later. All right, then enjoy the rest of the conference.
Bye. Thank you.
All right, so we're going to have our next session coming up shortly, but I'll be moving up from this stage. I will be going to room two for the next session. Please be on standby when the next person that will be chairing this this track will be on back, where you can be able to go on to continue to have wonderful sessions. All right, do enjoy the rest of the conference. Bye for now.